The politics of this country can be very interesting. Yesterday, Ndindi Nyoro, who is the member of parliament for Kiharu, refused to leave Royal Media offices for fear of being arrested after what happened between him and Maina Kamanda in Murang'a. And I've compiled for you his speech at Royal Media, which is coming up shortly. But something else very interesting also happened. And in my view, I strongly believe that Raila Odinga has started creating euphoria, either for 2022 elections or for the upcoming referendum. Yesterday, Raila Odinga attended a football match, the friendly match between Harambee Stars and Uganda Cranes. And after the match, Raila Odinga left the stadium as usual. But something happened. While he was leaving the stadium, the supporters blocked his convoy and escorted him up to town, to an extent that William Samoei Ruto, who was supposed to use that route, had to reverse his convoy because he was coming from Roysambu, had to reverse his convoy to use another route. And I think that's part of the strategy of Raila Odinga to build the euphoria. And this is how he was escorted. Watch that. Then briefly you'll watch how Moses Wetangula was received in Kibra, which in my view also surprised me. And then listen to Ndindi Nyoro. Watch.
Achukua video.
lakini mimi nafikiria pengine ni yale maneno ilikuwa leo imeonyeshwa kwa TV, na mimi I am very surprised that Kenya imefika hapo, ya kwamba wewe uko kwako in your constituency doing your work, lakini kwa sababu kuna kitu umefanya kuonekana uko na raia, na kuonekana uko na raia ukakasirisha watu, wanaona sasa kama uko na raia lazima sasa polisi wakukamate. Kwa hivyo mimi I'm just here, na ningetaka kuambia kwamba pengine watafute kazi ingine ya kufanya, kwa sababu kama niko na makosa mimi mbona niabii nitajipeleka wapi kesho, na naomba pengine mtanipea hiki itinerary hapa siku ya leo, kwa sababu kama kuna watu wanakugoja hapo nje, na of course ni yao sio mzuri, of course I cannot take myself there, but I want to say in Kenya we need some tolerance especially kwa siasa, kwa sababu ukiona mtu pengine amekuweza kisiasa, wacha kutumia serikali, muweze tu kisiasa. Na tuseme ya kwamba mimi kama mbunge wa Kiharu, niko na all the authority kuongea kwa katika Kiharu, kama kuna watu ni vizuri naongea kama mbunge huko, na kama nakamatwa kwa kuwa mbunge wa Kiharu leo, just to do what an MP should do, it's very unfortunate.
But if you're not, if you have nothing to fear, mbona usijisalimishe, mbona usiende usikie wanataka nini, wanakueleza nini, kama ni kukamata wakukamata wakupeleke kesho mahakamani kama hauna lolote la kuhofia?
Gashuri, you know, first of all, number one, I have actually seen on your TV kuna Land Rover hapo nje na kuna gari ingine hata sijui ni ya kina nani, na vile unajua siwezi jipeleka hapo, sijui kama ni majabazi wanatumia gari za polisi. I also have a family and a life to protect. Na kama kuna makosa, kuna process unafaa utumie katika nchi ya Kenya. Ningeuliza mimi, I am a very innocent person. Kama kuna kitu nimefanya, nielezwe na unatakikana pahali fulani, I'll be very glad to take myself there. But I cannot take myself into a problem that is waiting for me out there, na nikijua kabisa vita napigwa ni vita ya kisiasa. Kwa sababu unaelewa Kenya kwenye tumefika, the lines are drawn now. Na siku nafikiri imefika hapo, ya kwamba ukionekana uko mlengo huu, so you being is huddled kama a criminal. I've never stolen anyone's anything. I've never committed any criminality ever in my life. Kwa hivyo watu wasifikirie, watanitisha, pengine wanaona a young fellow, they see a guy whose parents are not known, maybe a hopeless fellow mwenye hajulikani hii Kenya, mama yake hajulikani, baba yake hajulikani. Kwa hivyo ukienda unaonekana kama unafanya kitu in your constituency ambayo watu wanapenda, then people are very eager to bring you down. I want to tell them ni sawa sawa, mimi naamini Mungu, na kama kuna makosa nimefanya ni Mungu tu anajua, but I know for sure if it is about today, people watched and the jury is out there.
Do I hear you say you're not living here at all?
Unless you Gashuri, mimi nalala hapa. So kama wananikujia hapa Royal Media
asubuhi,
kwa kiti ikikuwa sana kwa carpet, kwa sababu naelewa hii Kenya. How can I just walk to a problem nikiona watu sijui, and clearly they are waiting for me for something for sure, that sio kitu ya kuvanya polisi aache kazi ingine akuje hapa.
Okay. I see your lawyer Ali is a Wahome member of parliament for Kandara. What do you think your client is being sought for?
I watched the clip that came from Muranga, and I told Dede, because I saw outside the church there was already a contingent of police, and it is likely that they were even there for bad intentions. You saw that they were even attempting to arrest Mheshimiwa Dede while coming from the church. And I think, were it not for the loyal people of Kiharu, who of course witnessed the mishandling their MP was supposed to be going through, actually they resisted. But I told him, I think that they must be wanting to do some arrest, and therefore he was kind of expecting that they would come here. And for sure, I have come myself here because when I called him after Kirerembe, he told me he has now learned that we have two police Land Rovers outside the Royal Media gates, and I have personally witnessed as I drove through. I saw that, and I have advised him as a lawyer because I'm a lawyer who is in practice also. I've advised him that, one, the police cannot come to look for him here at night, this particular hour. This is not a criminal. It's a person in position of an elected position. The member of parliament for Kiharu cannot be sought for whatever could have happened, this or anything before then, at night by police, without knowing why and what intentions would make Kibichu, the PS, interior minister, send police to Royal Media, knowing that in fact there will be cameras outside.
But you have no information that it is the PS who has sent him.
These people work for, you know, there is politics in this thing. And even what happened in Kiharu is actually politics. And Minor Commander and his team, led by Wabogo Eskieleweke, obviously we are frustrated because the people of Kiharu are not willing to listen to garbage.
So what is your legal advice to your client?
He will stay, he will sleep here. Tomorrow, if police need him, we will present him to the police or even to court, a court of law. But we are not going to present him to people who we don't know. These are people with heinous actions. And Gashori, I want to disclose to the public, to the Kenyan public and the people of Kiharu and the people of Murang'a. I am saying this without fear of contradiction. I'm aware of a meeting that occurred in Murang'a last weekend, and it went up to 1 a.m. And it was led by a very senior businessman in Murang'a. The PS is said to have been there, Kibicho, and other two people that I will disclose as we go along in this particular matter. And the discussion was how to stop Ruto from presidency. And they discussed in terms of Murang'a County that Mheshimiwa Dede Nyoro and Mheshimiwa Aris Wahome must be cut off the main branch. The main branch in that manner be a reference of Deputy President William Ruto, but we must be crushed in whatever form, including death. I think there is fear of death.
Those are very serious allegations you're making, Mheshimiwa.
I'm making these allegations, and if I'm pushed, I will disclose the venue and the full details of the people who discussed very serious issues which are a threat to his life and my life. And it is important. I've just disclosed this. This information came to me. And when I heard Dede Nyoro was being sought from here at night, I came with this particular information. So my advice, both legal and, you know, as a Kenyan, that he should sleep here. We want Dede alive, and we want to present him to police daytime. There is no emergency. The police in this country must stop being used politically. This kind of games never win, will never work, because Kenyans under the new constitution have wide freedoms of expression and of movement.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Let's allow Jeff to, you want to say something about it?
I wanted to say, Gashuri, because we spoke about it on Kirirembe Show with my colleague Honorable Nyoro on the misuse of state agencies in this country, especially the police force. We must challenge the Inspector General of Police not to allow the police to continue being used to persecute politicians. Let every politician practice his politics the way they want. Let them support whoever they want to support. But no amount of intimidation, no amount of persecution will deter us from taking the positions that have taken. And let me confirm that we are here. We will spend the night here with Dindi Nyoro. If they want to storm here, they can storm here. If they do not want, we will present Dindi Nyoro to whatever police station they want during the day. But at night, for people we do not know. And I can tell you, you saw the robbery that was in Nairobi West the other day. People purporting to be police. How do we know these are policemen?
Thank you.
And not criminals.
Well, Gashuri, we are friends of Dede Nyoro. And what we need to say is that this state cannot be seen to always be working as if it's fighting its own people. And even worse, fighting the people who have been elected to represent the people of this country. I represent a Nairobi constituency. You know what the rates of crime are in Nairobi. So if we have policemen who are being designated to do these kind of jobs at night, while they should be taking care of the security of Kenyans, then we feel that the state is misusing some of these resources. And these resources I'm talking about is police. Now, what is ironic, we have a wildly popular show here at RMS called Kirirembe. and you know, I'm a panelist, and today nilikuwa nimeketi kwa bench kama najionea Kirerebe, and immediately after we learned that there are people out there waiting to arrest Honorable Ndindi Nyoro for reasons that we do not know. Now you can never be able to tell whether these are real policemen or whether these are people purporting to be police out to harass. So I think us as friends of Dede, we are going to stand with him in solidarity. Kama ni kulala kwa bench hapa, tutalala kwa bench leo. Lakini ile tunasema ni kwamba serikali hii haiwezi onekana ni kama kila wakati inapigana na wananchi wake, kulazimisha kila kitu ambacho serikali inajaribu kujifanya, inafanya kwa kulazimisha.
Kwa nini nyinyi kama marafiki zake msiende mkongea na wale maafisa wa polisi? Find out why they want to arrest him, and if they have genuine reasons to arrest him, then hand him over.
We don't know who we are talking to, Ngashuri. We do not know who we are dealing with. We do not know if we are dealing with criminals. We do not even know why a matter, if it is a matter that happened in Murang'a, is being prosecuted outside the gate in Nairobi at Royal Media Services. So if it was a matter that was that critical, I think it would have been dealt with in Murang'a. And if Honorable Ndindi Nyoro is being arrested for what happened in Murang'a, I believe there are over 20 MPs who are in that meeting. We want to know whether they are at any other person's gate to be arresting anyone else who was involved in that fracas there. But what I was saying is ironic is the fact that today, when we were discussing the matter of Murang'a, one member of parliament actually told us, because they'd started, and I've got to say this honestly, that the arrest of Mheshimiwa Ndindi Nyoro was actually premeditated. It was premeditated long before even the issues that happened at the Catholic Church. Because a member of parliament today, when we were talking about what is happening in Murang'a, started sending messages that Ndindi has been arrested. And when I contested that, this member of parliament told me that to wait until the day is over.
Okay.
So who are these members of parliament who have control over police?
Thank you very much. Actually, your final word is...
There is something that I needed to say. Actually, the procedure of arresting a member of parliament is actually, there is a requirement that you notify the speaker and the clerk of the National Assembly of a requirement that there is maybe the member of parliament is being sought, and a short statement as to the reasons that the member of parliament is being sought, and indeed presented to the speaker, and then parliamentary police station that is just opposite to parliament, and therefore the reason that we are not willing.
Mheshimiwa, that would sound like there are two sets of law.